Hi, I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. The best use cases for ChatGPT, a popular chatbot based on an advanced AI language model, are yet to be found. This video gives an idea of how to use the ChatGPT and any AI tools that can help your academic writing. When writing a paper, thesis, or dissertation, these tools may help you with the following steps. 1. Developing a research question with ChatGPT. By creating and improving possible questions, you may benefit from using the ChatGPT service to help define a clear and concise research question. You may have a great deal of research questions to work out in the short term thanks to ChatGPT. It's an excellent way for us to come up with ideas and divergent approaches on a topic. But make sure that the questions you have generated are relevant and meet your needs. For example, ask to ChatGPT, develop 3 possible research questions on the following topic: the influence of social media on political opinion formation. ChatGPT generated the possible research question according to your research. Further, you type, based on the second research question, develop 3 further research questions on the topic of polarization in U.S. politics. Build my scientific method, qualitative discourse analysis, into each question. Include the term filter bubble in each question. You can see ChatGPT generated according to your topic. Next, you can write on chatbot. Try to incorporate qualitative discourse analysis into the questions themselves, instead of using it as a separate sentence. 2. Creating an outline of your paper with ChatGPT. In addition, you could use the ChatGPT service to draw up a research paper or thesis proposal. Try generating headings and subheadings that can be improved upon in order to do this. ChatGPT is able to help with the creation of a clear and well-structured outline, especially if you keep adjusting your structure thanks to its assistance. It doesn't seem to know your topic very well, though. For this reason, it can be possible to generate inappropriate headings. The outline needs to be checked if it makes sense and all the relevant points are addressed in answering your research question. The headings and subheadings should also be structured in such a manner that they comply with the logic. For example, you can type on chatbot, create an outline for an academic research paper with the following research question. What is the contribution of a qualitative discourse analysis to understanding the role of filter bubbles in perpetuating and reinforcing political echo chambers in the US? The paper will be about 8 pages long. Further, this seems like too much information to fit into only 8 pages. Can you condense the outline, for example, removing the appendices and simplifying the structure? 3. Generate literature ideas. ChatGPT can provide a good way to generate ideas on what sources you might want to use for your work. Try asking it for suggestions about where to look and what to consider. However, we recommend that you don't use it to find a source on the spot. It is not designed for it, and often, when required to do so, fake sources are created in order to make them appear authentic. Instead, you can search a database like Google Scholar. For example, type, what types of sources could I use to write a paper on the following research question? What is the contribution of a qualitative discourse analysis to understanding the role of filter bubbles in perpetuating and reinforcing political echo chambers in the US? Four, paraphrasing text. You'll also be able to use the ChatGPT method for paraphrasing text. A number of similar paraphrases for the same concept can be produced rapidly by ChatGPT. If you don't feel satisfied with the outcome of this chat, please continue to type, again, in it. For example, those who are not native English speakers can benefit from such paraphrasing in order to improve the coherence of their language. I'm just telling you, watch out. The paraphrases often contain grammatical errors, include false information. For example, paraphrase the following text. A filter bubble results from a social media algorithm's attempts to cater to an individual user based on data such as their search history and previous behavior on the site. It results in the user only being presented with information that confirms their biases. Restructure the sentences and use other phrasings for the following parts. 1. Results from, 2. Only being presented with. 5. Getting feedback from ChatGPT. It is also possible to receive feedback on arguments and structure of your paper, as well as suggestions for improvement through ChatGPT. One advantage of this is you can always get feedback from the ChatGPT on different quotes at any point in time. One drawback is that the ChatGPT does not have a detailed understanding of your research question, which may result in superficial or inappropriate feedback and suggestions. For example, behave like a scientific supervisor in their office hours. You must review and critically assess the current state of this section of my research paper. To do this, evaluate the clarity of my explanations, the smoothness of the language, and the way I've structured the text, giving constructive criticism on each issue. Text you want to get feedback. 6. Limitations of ChatGPT. Even though ChatGPT is a powerful writing tool, you should keep the following limitations in mind. 1. No original research. 2. Risk of plagiarism. 3. Fake sources. 4. Fake facts. 1. No original research. The AI trained the ChatGPT to use current texts and used these data for writing its own text. It is unable to conduct its own research, only synthesizes the sources from which it was trained. In addition, it is not familiar with more recent world events, cultural trends, and developments in various research areas, since the texts it has been trained in are only valid until 2021. As a result, it may provide outdated information. 2. Risk of plagiarism. The artificial intelligence tends to apply the content in such a way that it could be regarded as plagiarizing, because ChatGPT has been taught using current text. In its replies, the AI will be capable of copying texts from an online publication. Additionally, using ChatGPT to write your assignment for you is considered plagiarism regardless of where it got the content from, because you're passing off something you didn't write as your own work. 3. Fake sources. The ChatGPT was trained in a variety of sources, but it does not yet know how each source will be used for the output. It is even more apt to invent sources which don't really exist when asked. Furthermore, ChatGPT is not intended to be a citation generator and cannot be used to add properly formatted citations to your work. 4. Fake facts. When it comes to providing you with accurate information, ChatGPT is not always trustworthy. It doesn't intentionally lie, and in a traditional sense, it does not have any knowledge or ability to verify its claim. Thank you for watching. Like, share and subscribe my channel for more informative videos.